Hello, and welcome to episode 3 in the Forever Stranded series. Now, I just wanted to say, all 3 of these episodes that have come out, the first 3, have all been filmed back-to-back, so I did not look at any feedback or see any comments or anything. If there were some, I missed it. But today, what we're going to start on is we are going to start on getting some sieved materials here. That's the next quest in the line, I believe. Oh, no, that's right. That's what we were going to work on, was getting some of the, getting some of the dirty water here. Because we got to finish up that quest first, and then we'll get to the sieving stuff. And we'll get to it. So we put that together. Boom, we come out with a dirty water bottle. So let's see, what's next? We need 4 dirt. Well, that should not be particularly hard to get to. I'm really trying not to use the cactus here, because that is going to be much better for water and stuff like that. But we got to do what we got to do. So let's get on some of this tree business. Ooh, and we have to be careful here, because if we were to just vein mine this, then it would also destroy all the leaves of the apple tree there. There we go, that's a good clear separation, so then we can do that, and do this. Alright, let's go ahead and try to sleep. Alright, there we go, and then we can watch as the normal type monsters begin to die. And let's do this again. And I don't have any more of those in my inventory. So let's go ahead and make a couple more. And then we will get this one all taken down. Get this one all taken down. Alright. There we go. Collect this here mature apple. Got a good crop going there. Go ahead and put those in there. Now let's see where this is the line, and that's the one with Snad. All right, so let's go ahead and step out here. Gonna see about collecting some of these resources that the monsters are leaving behind. Alright, there we go, and we got nitre. Nitre. I wonder what that can be used for in this pack. I honestly did not get to the more advanced stages of progression there, so I would not for sure know. I don't like that there's stuff spawning inside my house here. I'm gonna guess that it's spawning in there, but I am honestly just not going to worry about it. I tell you truthfully, I'm just not going to worry about it. So let's get some more of this done. Because what we're really needing right now is to get that dirt. We are needing to get that dirt. And if that is the case where we need to get that dirt, then we need saplings. Because that's the best way to get dirt in this particular stage that we're at. Let's collect some more cacti. Because very, very soon, we are going to need to do something with that. soon as we can get through this quest and move on to the next one. That's when we're going to start worrying about the cacti. 56%. All right, it's getting there. It's getting there. Let's collect a little bit more wood while we're waiting on that there. Probably just need to move this away. Oh, we are beginning to overheat. We are beginning to overheat. That's definitely something that we need to be concerned about. But we're almost to the point where we can start taking care of that. There we go. 4 pieces of dirt. And that should be that quest complete. Ah, it's going to consume them, so we have to tell it to. Alright, and then we can claim it. We got 5 dirt and a lifeblood crystal. Lifeblood crystal's going to, boop, give us a 5th heart. Isn't that nice? Isn't that nice? Alright, so then we're going to move on to this one, which is the Oak Crucible and the Unfired Bucket. Mostly the Oak Crucible. That's the one that we're really super interested in here. So let me get some planks here. Some of this stuff. I'm probably going to burn out. I'm going to not be surprised if I burn out, because I have not really gotten to a stage where I can take care of this yet. So let's see, get an Oak Crucible. Yep, get one of those going, fantastic. And then we'll just put it here, I suppose, and then throw some cactus in. I'm not able to put any cactus in. Aw, no, they changed it. One of the updates took the ability, well, you can't turn cactus into water anymore? Wow. So I guess now it's the other way around, where cactuses are what you use for dirt and trees are what you use for water. Well, almost assuredly now I am going to burn out. That's gonna happen. Because getting the unfired bucket is not something that I'm at yet, because that requires like having stone and a furnace and all kinds of other things. I thought, anyways, let me take a look here. Oh, I'd probably find this quicker with unfired. There's nothing we can do about that heat, guys. We're gonna die. So we're just gonna not even worry about it. We're gonna let that go, and we're gonna die right here in the center, and then spawn on our beds and be right back. There's nothing we can do about that at this stage, guys. I really wish there was, but there is not. And then we're going to take this little note and boop, right into the cactus. So then let's move all this down a step to have it where I want it to be. Get rid of that. That's a piece of the ship right there, which I have a couple of coordinates marked here. This is the home base. This is the ship. I just took them off so that they're not showing up here. But that's actually a piece of the ship that I carved out. Okay. So yeah, if we need to move on from that, because we don't have the bucket or the cobblestone, then it really is down to sieving. That's the next step, is the sieving. So let's go ahead and just like that. And see if we can get ourselves, I think a furnace is going to have to be our first thing. I was hoping that we could go for the, a cobble gin with just a piece of lava and water right away, but if we can't, then we're going to have to do it that way. It just seems like the quests are kind of out of order if that's the case. Because I know from the look of it, this quest here, this is going to be... this is going to be getting the crucible, which is how you get lava. So how else would you get an unfired bucket? Porcelain clay, which is only made with ash, which is only made from burning sticks. That just seems so weird. that is how it wants us to go about it. Because it's required for us to have a furnace first, which is... Oh well. I guess it isn't really out of order, it just seems strange to me. It isn't how I would have chosen to done it. But yeah, so let's go ahead and do some of this business. I'm gonna try to save one, because I really want a third patch, or a third tree growing out here. So I'm gonna come over here, make sure that I'm like four away from any of the cacti, and then go ahead and put that down, and then do another tree. And then just for the sake of those that need it, I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna move this tree over there, because I'm tired of having to take that stuff apart anyways. So then we'll put that sand back down, take this dirt in, and continue this sieving process. And what we're shooting for is just those small stones. We're trying really hard to give ourselves enough that we can make enough cobblestone, but it's such a drawn out process, because it's like this, and that makes one piece, and we need a minimum of 8 to get a furnace, and then, you know, we can explode out from there depending. But yeah, so I think we need a total of 12, because we're gonna need 8 to make a furnace, and then 4 more to get our first bucket of lava. So yeah, this is going to be a while, and it's going to be really boring to watch, so I'm going to cut here. I will come back once I've gathered enough dirt and stuff to be able to get us a furnace, and the 4 more that we need for after that. I'll see you guys in a minute. So yeah, I'm in process here. I'm doing some stuff, but I wanted to bring you back to show something that I forgot about until I was really struggling trying to figure out like what would be the best way to get some of this dirt going. You can see that in my hand there I have something called wood chippings. So I just wanted to show that that's got from taking logs and taking the hammers to it. And then you get more of that, and that is kind of a cheap way to get dirt as well. It's just another compostable material. And since basically once you have trees, you have infinite wood, or as close to it as matters, it's a good way to get yourself started on the dirt production. So yeah, I'm going to get back at that, and I'll be back in a minute. Alright guys, so I got enough for the furnace together. I'm gonna go ahead and pull that out, and then pull out the rest of these small stones so that we can go ahead and put that together. Boom! We have a furnace now. Now it's not something that I'm gonna want to run constantly, because I do have to worry still about overheating a good bit. But yeah, we can start to get cranking on the things that are related to that. Oh, hold on. There we go. Keep those wood chips coming, so that way I can keep on generating that dirt. But yeah, so we're gonna go ahead, I think, and put together that bucket. So what we need is we need a piece of dust. We'll just hold on to him for a second. Then we're gonna go ahead and get that. Then we got ourselves some clay. Break that up into the individual pieces. And then we need some sticks. We need three of them. At the very least. Okay, so let's do this intelligently to save our resources, right? So two sticks will make one charcoal. And we'll back up so that we're not getting the heat off of that onto us. Yeah. Yep. And then we've got three pieces of bone meal still. I've been having to take down these bones and just, you know, turn them into bone meal like that. Because I started to run out of the initial supply, because I was getting tired of waiting for the trees to grow, you know? Actually, now that it's day, and while we're waiting on that anyways, let's go ahead and... Yeah, we'll go... See, this is one of the other things that I've been doing, is I've been... You know, waiting for day to hit, and then as soon as that's the case, I've been coming out here to deal with the husks sort of one-on-one, if you will, and also collect all of the drops that have just been left, like, on the ground. And that's how I've been collecting all of the rotten flesh that I've been using to turn into dirt. I've also, as you can see from the skull on my barb, and of course I would be recording when that happened. But what I was trying to say there is that I've been using the time wisely to kill all of the different monsters, and I have, of course, already killed some creepers as well, because you would have seen in my on my hotbar even. Yeah, right there, I have a creeper skull. I knew I shouldn't have gone in for that creeper kill. I should have backed off, played it safe, and then go ahead and kill that thing. Oh, it is frustrating to die. I mean, admittedly, it reset my temperature, and I think gave me a little bit more food, so I guess I shouldn't complain too much. Dying is just a thing that happens in this pack, as near as I can tell. That's one of the reasons why I didn't bother activating hardcore mode, because I would very quickly end up with a deleted world. I just don't have the skills to really succeed on this day one. Maybe I'm taking it at too relaxed a pace. Who knows? See, let me put that cactus back. Go ahead and tear these down to collect some more materials, because there's rotten flesh, and also, you know, like I said, this is my cactus farm at the moment. Yep. I'd be really interested in getting a sugar cane seed, but the game has not been kind on that front just yet. So let me fill a couple of these up now. Yep, I should have the stuff for it. To get four more pieces in total. Fantastic. And then let's step over here. So we got that one piece of charcoal. So let's do that and make eight more charcoal. Oh, apple grow. I'm gonna have to delete that marker. It's gonna kind of bother me if I don't do that. Okay. Okay, so now we're just waiting on that to cook up, and then we're going to make this unfired bucket. Yep. Okay. Also, whew, I wonder how many saplings it takes to get one of those. Because it used to be 4 cactuses. It was a very, very equitable trade there. Yeah, more than I have available. Okay, so let's step out here. I'm going to use up some of this bone meal. And by use up some, I mean have to make more. Okay. And then let's tear that down. Make ourselves... Oh, I actually had another one in my inventory already. Tear that down. Tear that down. That down. We'll come over here and grab this one time too. Okay. Then we'll step back inside here. Looks like that charcoal is done. Fantastic. And then we will do 8 sticks. Just so that we're, you know, making good use of our resources. I think that's gonna be... Yeah, that's gonna come out to... Nope. Maybe that. Yeah, that should come out... Yeah, that'll come out to 1 bucket of water. So gosh, it is a lot of saplings. Ooh, water's a lot harder to come by now than it was before. That's unfortunate. Oh well, oh well, oh well. So let's look at that. That's the 3 that we need. And then it was that. If I remember, it was the ash. It was the bone meal. And then it was the clay. And then we get that porcelain clay. And then it is the... porcelain clay, like that, like that, like that. Boom, we got ourselves an unfired bucket. Let's get some more sticks. And there we go. So an unfired bucket. Did that finish the quest? No, because we have to have a water bucket that is, I imagine, the fired bucket filled with water. And then we'll get ourselves a canteen and 4 more oak saplings. Once that's done, we can actually start trying to take care of ourselves here with the heat a little bit. I'm going to go ahead, and just because we're moving around and there's a lot of furnacing going on, I actually had this from day one. It's one of the starter things. It's a splash potion of heat resistance. If you have any debuff at all, it'll just crash your game when you activate it. But since I don't, I can throw it down. And then I have heat resistance now. So my heat, I think that stops your heat from going up. It doesn't. It's not like you have a temperature down gauge or anything. It just stops it from going up at all. So there we go, there's that, and then again, just to be like super serious with our resource management, 2 sticks, and then the unfired bucket, and then that should give us the fired bucket. Boom, we got ourselves a bucket, and then boom, we got ourselves a water bucket, and that's that quest complete. So let's go ahead and claim that. And then, now we're on to this. So this is the next thing that I'm super serious about getting done. Because once this is done, then we can explode out on trying to get our resources done. Because then we'll have basically infinite cobblestone once we can get 1 bucket of lava. So what we're going to do first is... probably over here... just because this is where I'm going to spend most of my time, I'm going to put that water in there, and then you can see we can get down in it, and if we, you know, kind of hop in and out of it, then our temperature goes down. And so now we have a very rudimentary way of managing our temperature. Isn't that fantastic, guys? So I'm going to get back on to the... I'm gonna get back on getting the small stones that we need. We're up to two and a little bit extra, so two more of those guys, and we'll be able to make our first bucket of lava. I'll be back. Alright guys, I had to bring you back because I made a bit of an update out here. So since I was able to start cooking up charcoal, I've made plenty of torches, and I expanded the wall out a little bit so that I could have some room to grow. Also, I have gotten all of the stones together I need to make that 4 pieces of cobblestone. So I'm going to come in here, we're going to grab that out. I've also made the porcelain clay for the next bit, so we're going to go ahead and get that too. Got an unfired crucible. So let's check that quest, just to make sure we're on the right path. Good, it's not a consume quest. So of course, the next part of that is to take 2 sticks, once again, throw that in there, and let it become a fired crucible. Well, I think it's just actually crucible, but let it get finished cooking up. Fantastic. And then let's see, where would be... Well, honestly, it's going to be super duper temporary anyways, but I'm just going to put it over here. Put a torch down, put the crucible down, take the 4 pieces of cobblestone, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then let that slowly turn into lava. And once that's turned into lava, we will be at the point where we have infinite cobblestone. We can start making better tools, better weapons. We can start building a little bit if we want to use cobblestone for that, although I'm not really sure about it. I'm really thinking I want to stick with this deserty palette and go with some sandstone. Maybe get some hardened clay if I can find some of that. I'm trying to stay out here during night because I really want to take a look and make sure that this wall is going to hold up. I haven't seen any gaps. There isn't any spawnable squares on this side of it. I mean, of course, skeletons and things like that can still get at me by shooting me, so I'm not trying to attract their attention. But yeah, it looks like the wall is good, and it looks like I didn't leave any spawnable squares, so we're probably fantastic there. Oh. But yeah, so we're gonna wait. Let's see, how long is that? Ah, God, it takes forever with a torch. I forget every time. It's so slow. So slow. Real quick, we're gonna cut and then come back once that's finished. Alright, and we are back. Go ahead and grab this up, and then hopefully be able to... Yeah, good, I can just complete that quest. Claim, cha-ching, tools of the trade, stone hammer, bone crook, and that. Those are the new quests that opened up. I did do a little area over here. I went ahead and made it ready. And we've got ourselves a cobblestone generator. Isn't that fantastic, guys? So now we can just sit here and get this cobblestone as much as we need. No stopping us. I'll have to work on that a little bit better to see if maybe I can refine it. And also, I'll try to do something to keep that room cool. I just added it as like a little side addition on the temple. I'm going to check the time on the episode, but I think that's going to wrap it up. So yeah, I went and checked the episode, and this is going to have to do it for us today. I hope you all have enjoyed the episode. If you did, please leave a like down below. Also, feel free to tell anybody you know that they should come and check my channel out. More subscribers equals more motivation equals more episodes. And hopefully, sometime in the very near future, you will also see some of the other stuff that I'm working on. I've talked to a few people about it. I'm going to start just doing like... not gonna say daily, because that's a bit ambitious, but semi-daily videos that I'm just gonna call highlight reels of the various things that I end up playing online with people or with friends or whatever, just to try to keep the channel updated. Anyways, now that you know my plans and you've seen these three episodes, I'm going to take a break for a little bit, and then I will have you back on another day. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.